Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. In today's video, I'm going to be talking about MetaMask. I'm going to briefly explain what it is, what it's used for, some vulnerability points, and then we're going to set up a burner account together. If you like more of these contents, make sure you smash that like and subscribe button. All right, let's get started. So MetaMask is a cryptocurrency wallet, and a cryptocurrency wallet allows you to interact with the blockchain and interact with decentralized applications, such as participating in NFTs or crypto gaming or even decentralized finance, such as staking or yield farming. If you guys want to learn more about those topics, make sure you check out my video over here. A crypto wallet holds both your private and your public keys. And the way I like to think about it is kind of like your traditional online banking. Your public keys are kind of like your email address in which you would share with somebody else so that they can send you funds or money. And then private keys are kind of like your online banking password in which you would never share with anybody, or else you give people access to your account to make unauthorized transactions to take money out. MetaMask is considered a hot wallet. And a hot wallet means that your wallet is connected to the internet, which makes it inherently subject to online scammers and hackers. As for the flip side, a cold wallet is a crypto wallet that is not connected to the internet, and so it's likely in a form of a USB, and so the private keys are stored within the physical cold wallet, so they're less prone to online hackers. I do have an affiliate link below for the famous Ledger wallet. It's a cold wallet. It's highly recommended because every day there's new stories about hackers hacking people, and this is a form of protecting your assets. So for those of you who are new to this space, whenever you interact with a decentralized application, the website or the application will ask you to connect your wallet, which is going to be your MetaMask, right? And so with emerging technology, all of the scammers and hackers, they are becoming way more sophisticated. So some common hacks is that scammers will create a fraudulent website that replicates the official website that you're trying to access. And then what they're going to do is ask you to connect your wallet. They're going to ask you maybe for your seed phrase. Do not ever give away your seed phrase. I'll get into that later on in the video. And so whenever you're interacting with a decentralized application, such as you're minting NFTs, or if you're trying to find the newest crypto that no one knows about yet for the really, really crazy return, that could be super shady. You just have to be very careful because you do have to connect your wallet. Recently, there was a huge NFT fraud that happened, the biggest one in NFT history. As soon as they were gonna mint, they connected their wallets. The money was drained from everybody who connected their wallets. The Discord group was locked so that nobody could advise anybody. And then now if you Google it, the whole operation, all the websites, the Twitter, everything is closed down. And so to prevent this from happening is you can make burner accounts. Right. And so the purpose of the burner account is so that you have just enough crypto in those burner accounts so that if in the event that you do actually get compromised, the only thing that attacker can take is that little bit of crypto that you have in that burner account. And so today we're gonna go ahead and make a burner account together. Whether it's your burner account or your first account, the methodology is still the same way of setting it up. And really, there's actually two ways of creating a burner account. The first way that I personally would not use because I'd be too paranoid. And then there's a second way. So the first way is super, super easy. It's gonna be like if you already have an existing MetaMask account, you just go up here to the bar section and then you simply click this and you could just say create an account, just like that, create. And then now it's creating that brand new account. And then over here, you'll see it. I personally would not go with this option because I would be way too paranoid. I would make a brand new wallet altogether.
So how I would do it is I would create a totally new profile on my Chrome. So I just open up Tester Crypto and I would go ahead and download the MetaMask extension. And you have to make sure that it's the official one. So MetaMask.io. So once you're here, it's an extension basically. So you just go to download, then it's Chrome extension, could also be like Firefox, Edge, etc. So you just download it here. It'll take you to the Chrome store, you add it to your extension. So go on to this puzzle piece here. These are all of your extensions. What I would do is I would pin it. And so now you want to get started. So you can either do, you have a secret recovery phrase or a yes, set up a brand new account. So I'm creating a totally brand new wallet for my burner account. And first here, you would say either you want to help them or not. It's really up to you, but I'm going to say no thanks. And so over here, you create a password, what you use to log in. Okay, so after you type in your password, now they're going to make you watch a video about your secret recovery phrase. Make sure you do not give this secret phrase out to anybody. So it's going to be 12 words in a specific chronological order. So make sure you watch this video here, okay, guys? So next, you're going to have to click here to reveal your secret phrases. Make sure you write it down somewhere, and you have to write it in the same order, because after they show it to you, you're going to have to re-enter it in.
And I forgot to mention that when you're taking note of your seed phrase, do not save the seed phrase electronically. Like, don't take a photo of it on your iPhone that has cloud storage. Don't take a screenshot of it on your computer, because then the hackers, if they hack into your computer, then they can get access to your seed phrase. Write down a couple versions just in case. Maybe also let somebody know who you do trust a lot.
After you enter in your seed phrase, it's gonna get you to this page here. Yeah, so once you're here, you just say, and then so now you're set up. MetaMask is mainly on Ethereum. However, you can add other networks into it as well too. So over here, there is EtherScan is basically a website that will show you all of the transactions that you've made on this wallet. So if you were to have done purchase, sold, swap, whatever, you'll see it kind of all be listed down here. And then that's kind of your public address. You're giving away your public address for like an airdrop or minting or something like that. Just to protect yourself, this is the burner account. Over here, once you click here, you'll see that there is only Ethereum mainnet. And then if you want to add more networks, add their network with these information. These can be found on the specific coins website. Make sure, again, it's the official website. You could also import coins as well too. So if you're on, you know, Ethereum ERC20, you go to import tokens, you can either search or you can do custom tokens. If it's a coin that isn't popular on the search, then you can go and find the token contract address. And so it'll be something on like CoinMarketCap. You'll see the contract address here. Make sure that it is a legitimate contract address. And then also you could search tokens. So such Decentraland maybe. So yeah, so Mana here, if you just press that, okay, import token. You would have it under your Ethereum mainnet. You'll have the different type of tokens. And then some other setting items that you might want to look at is if you go into settings and you go to advanced, there's gonna be some certain things where you can sync with mobile, or then you can reset your account. Resetting your account doesn't wipe out your balance, but it kind of wipes out the transaction history, I believe. There's also advanced gas controls. And then there's also the auto timer lockout, or if you're idled for more than 5 minutes and you don't access your MetaMask, it'll automatically log you out, which is really important. So whenever you are connected on MetaMask, highly suggest you to avoid really sketchy websites. If you watch my first ever video, you'll notice that one of the problems that I had when I was trying to bridge my tokens was due to MetaMask setting. And I'm still going to leave it at that right now. Basically, it's the setting here when you right click. MetaMask can read and change data sites. It says all sites. I usually will have it on when you click on the extension only. And then now I've learned my lesson is that if you're going to be bridging or something, make sure you change it back to allow allowing it to do for all sites for that time being. So over here, this is your address. So if you clip it, it'll be this like long string chain of numbers and letters.
And then at the end, whenever you're done, make sure you lock the account. So what you would do is
you click up here, you do lock, and now it will take you out. And so yeah, whenever you want to access it, you just use the password, not your seed phrase, your password.
And so there you have it. I hope today's video, you were able to learn a little bit about MetaMask, as well as different precautionary ways to safely play within this crypto way, protecting yourself and protecting your assets, which is super important. If you made it all the way until the end of the video, thank you so much for watching. If you guys wanna see more content like this, make sure you smash that like button, smash that subscribe button, and I'll see you next time. Take care.